Hi, and welcome to the first and hopefully many Snipe-IT user video tutorials. My name is Alison, and I'm the lead developer on the Snipe-IT project. Today, we're going to cover how to use custom fields and field sets for assets in Snipe-IT. Custom fields allow you to create and store arbitrary data that's important to your organization, but that isn't necessarily an out-of-the-box Snipe-IT asset field. Custom fields belong to field sets, which get associated with asset models. If that sounds confusing, it's okay. We're going to walk you through it from start to finish. First, from your dashboard, we'll click on the gear icon in the lower left sidebar menu and select Asset Models. This shows a list of all of the asset models within Snipe-IT and some information about each model, including how many assets of that model type exist in Snipe-IT and what custom field sets, if any, are associated with each model. As you can see, we currently have no custom field sets associated with any models. Let's fix that. First, we go to the gear icon to get to our settings menu, and we select custom fields. As you can see, we have no custom fields set up. Fortunately, setting up custom fields in Snipe-IT is easy. Since I know we have computer assets and also mobile device assets such as cell phones in our inventory, we can create a custom field for each additional piece of data we want to collect. Let's start with some common ones. RAM, CPU, OS and version, such as Mac OS High Sierra, IMEI, and phone number. Right now you might want to stop me and tell me that computers don't normally have IMEI numbers and phone numbers. Well, that's right, but we can create all of the custom fields we need at once and then use field sets, which act like containers or buckets for your fields, to organize them all later. So let's start by creating a custom field for random access memory. We have the option of creating a text box, a single selection list box, or a multi-line text box. Since the amount of RAM available in most devices is quantifiable, let's do a list box. When the possible values of a custom field are finite, it's often helpful to use a list box to prevent data entry errors. We have multiple options for the types of data we want to allow for this field when assets are created or edited, including alphanumeric, email, date, and so on. But in this case, let's just use text. We can also add a helpful note that will be displayed under your custom fields entry box when an admin is creating or editing assets. Additionally, we have the option to include the value of this field in the check-in and check-out confirmation emails that your users receive. Or you can choose to encrypt this field in the database. It is important to note that encrypted custom fields cannot be sorted or searched on, and they cannot be displayed in confirmation emails. Great, our first custom field set is saved, so let's add the CPU and OS version fields. We've sped these up a little to save time. When we get to IMEI, we could set the format to any and hope the person entering the data got it right, or we could use some regular expression magic to enforce custom rules on our data. Simply select Custom Regex as the format and enter your regular expression in the Custom Regex format box. Any valid regular expression will work, but it must start with regex and the colon symbol. And finally, let's add phone number. Now we have all the custom fields we want to work with for now. Don't worry, we can always add more later. It's time to create some field sets. As we mentioned, field sets function like a container for your custom fields to group them together so that you can easily associate collections of custom fields to your asset models. Each asset model can only have one custom field set, but you can create an unlimited number of field sets with an unlimited number of field combinations. For this video, we'll focus on the two field sets we discussed earlier, computers and mobile devices. The computer field set should have RAM, CPU, and OS, while the mobile devices field set should have IMEI, phone number, and OS. Once you've created your new field set, you can select the fields you'd like to add to it using the drop-down shown. If you'd like the field to be required, be sure to click the required checkbox. Because we've already created the OS custom field, we don't need to create it again. We just associate the existing OS field set to the new mobile devices field set we created. Now when we look at our custom fields listing, we can see that they've been assigned to the correct field sets. We're not quite done yet though. Field sets don't belong to any asset models yet, so these fields won't display on any new or edited assets. So let's go back to our asset models listing. You can assign custom field sets to models one by one, or bulk edit your asset models and assign a field set to multiple at one time. To assign a field set to multiple asset models, simply select their checkboxes, click on Bulk Edit, select the field set you'd like to use, and click Save. Our new field sets now show up in the asset models listing. Now, when we create a new asset, your new custom fields will automatically appear when adding or editing assets of that asset model type. And that's it. You're now an expert in custom fields and custom field sets in Snipe-IT. That's all for now. See you next time.